Back when AMD first announced their anti-lag feature E3 2019, a lot of people, including me, were kinda skeptical. And since the new RX 5700 and 5700 XTs have just launched and the feature is now available to everyone, I thought I'd take a look at it, and especially since the new RTX Super GPUs are just about to come out, and that you've probably already seen quite a few reviews of these cards kind of on the whole with this feature probably only slightly mentioned, I thought I would do a bit of a more in-depth look at it. So in this video, I want to work out two things. The first is, does anti-lag actually do anything, like, at all? And if it does, the second thing is it actually any help, or is it more of those, one of those that's kind of technically better but not really actually useful kind of thing? But first, a message from this video's sponsor, Pulseway. Their RMM software allows you to control, manage, and secure your PCs from anywhere, from your phone or from their web dashboard. They've got agents for Windows, macOS, and Linux, and they've got a whole load of awesome features, including stuff like notifications on your phone if anything goes wrong on your systems. It's free for average folks like me for up to 2 systems, and business customers can get 2 months free with the promo code in the description down below, but either way, there's links down there that you can check out. So first, we have to establish if it actually does anything. Now this is fairly easy, because a while ago I made a mouse to do this exact thing, which is basically just an LED soldered to the left click, so that when you press the button, the LED goes out. Now on AMD slides, they reckon that you can get anywhere between 20 and 35% input lag reduction, which is actually quite a big deal. I was testing in CSGO, a game where input lag and response times actually make quite a big difference. I was testing with a TN 144Hz monitor just for good measure too. I also tested an RTX 2070 as a bit of a control and to make sure that all things were good there, again with the same setup, and the actual test itself is from when the LED on the mouse goes out to when you see the muzzle or the tip of the gun in-game kick backwards from recoil. And of course that's across multiple shots as well, so that we can get an average and give you an idea of, on average, how long it will take you to click your mouse and have something happen in-game. I also tested at 60Hz and 140Hz too, just to make sure as well. So, what are the results? Well, as expected, 60Hz is slower than 144, but only by 1 or 2 milliseconds on average, and so not a massive deal. But the real answer here is that yes, anti-lag does actually work. When taking a look at the 144Hz results, you can see that the average with the RX 5700 XT for the input lag there was 29 milliseconds. For reference, the RTX 2070 was 26 milliseconds, and so pretty close there. But with anti-lag on, you're looking at 19. That's almost a third faster. So anti-lag works, but does it actually help you in game? Can you notice it? For that, I got my partner to turn it on or off without me knowing what state it was in, and then I would play a bit and then make a guess as to if it was on or off. We also ran this multiple times, both on 60 and 144Hz, so that we could get an accurate understanding and not just chance. At 60Hz, it seemed to make a noticeable enough difference that I guessed all 3 runs correctly, which is nice to see. At 144Hz though, it was a lot more difficult, and through we ran the test multiple times, so a total of 9 runs, and of the 3 sets, I only ever got 1 or at most 2 out of 3 correct, which is really no better than chance. Now that doesn't mean that it won't help you in-game. Lowered input lag is always better, and that test doesn't track anything like accuracy, reaction times, or even in-game metrics like kills or deaths, so it's certainly not a foolproof test. The conclusion here is that AMD has done some really impressive work, and if you're picking up some of their new cards, or even if you have some of their older ones, anything that uses the GCN architecture will happily run this feature on DirectX 11 titles. Sadly, only DirectX 9 titles will run on the newer Navi cards, but either way, it's still something you should probably enable and get the free benefit from, even if it can have a slight impact on your in-game FPS. With that said, if you'd like to see anything else tested with these cards or this feature, then do let me know in those comments down below. I'd also love to hear your thoughts on the feature. Is it a bit more of a gimmick to you, or is it something that you could see tangible benefit in? All of that in the comments down below would be awesome. Of course, if you want to pick up these cards, I'll leave a link to them in the description down below. They did only release yesterday, so do bear that in mind. And also, if you want to see more videos like this one or videos with these cards, then feel free to hit that subscribe button with a bell notification icon. We have a load of videos coming out with the new Ryzen CPUs, these cards, the new PCIe Gen 4 SSDs, X570 motherboards and a whole load of other stuff, so if you're interested in any of that, make sure you're subscribed. You can also check out the links in the description down below to Amazon and Overclockers UK, so if you're buying the new Navi GPUs or Ryzen CPUs or even garden sheds on Amazon, it all helps and doesn't cost you anything, but it does massively help me out, so thank you to everyone who uses those. You can also check out merch like hoodies or t-shirts like this one or a load of other designs. You can also check out Patreon if you want to support the channel and get cool rewards for doing so, or there's also stuff like private internet access, which is a great and cheap VPN, or Humble Bundle for cheap games to support charities down there too. Otherwise, you can check out some other videos over here, including the Ryzen review that went out yesterday if you haven't seen that already, and otherwise that is pretty much it. If you have any questions, leave those in the comments down below, but otherwise we'll see you all in the next video.